And not needing to worry about exams. You gotta do what you gotta do. Are you getting ready for tonight? I texted Nate, told him to meet you at 7.
Great. I just hope he's not like all the other guys I've dated in his frat.
Nate's an awesome guy. He's totally the type of guy you need right now.
Well, from what you said, he does sound like a refreshing change of pace.
Well, let's just hope you don't break up with this one.
Well, let's just hope that Nate knows how to stay faithful to one person.
Hey guys, I'm going to dinner. Have fun on your date.
Thanks. Oh, my mom called today. She wants our families to have dinner together over graduation weekend.
The only way that dinner's happening is if I get to sit next to your older brother and there's an open bar. 72. Days until graduation. 72 days until life begins.
And only 72 days to find the man I'm gonna marry.
Oh, chill, Liza. Just live in the moment.
Hey, sorry I'm late.
Hey, you're good. I totally haven't been here that long.
Okay, cool, yeah. I can't believe we've never actually met before.
I know, like, sometimes the campus seems so small, but then I realize there's all these people I haven't even met before.
I know, right? We've definitely crossed paths a few times, so we have to. Morgan mentioned that you just got out of a tough relationship, right?
Yeah, but I'm totally over it. Aren't there more exciting things that you would like to talk about than my past failed relationships?
Okay, that's true. So, like, what about Morgan? How long have you guys known each other?
Well, we were in the same sorority freshman year, and we just ended up living together somehow ever since. Yeah, she's pretty great. I mean, she's the one that set this up, right?
Yeah, that's true. She does seem like a great person. I definitely want to get to know her a little better this semester.
Yeah, you should totally, like, hang out with us sometime. We do a lot of, like, really crazy things around campus.
Oh my god, I love that. I'll definitely have to see what the crazy is all about. So, like, what's the craziest thing you guys have done together?
Sophomore year, after, like, a full day of partying, Morgan went outside, and she ran... Actually, I mean, kind of seems like a breach of best friend conduct to tell you that story.
What? Oh my god, no, you have to tell me. You already started. You have to finish it now.
Maybe on our second date, I'll finish it.
Yeah. So, is Morgan always getting crazy drunk things, or?
She's known for her crazy sober habits, too. I don't know if you remember this, but last year at one of our socials, she was the sober monitor, and she still managed to outdance everyone at the social.
Yeah, I actually don't remember a lot of that, but I don't remember a lot of the socials I go to. So, like, tell me more.
About the social?
Yeah, sure, or just, like, more about Morgan.
Last year, when we were walking to one of the football games, I was wearing, like, heels, I don't know why, and I, like, slipped and I totally, like,
okay,
wiped
wait.
Out.
Can you hold on a sec? I actually kind of want to be honest with you.
Just a sec? I mean, you can always be honest with me.
Okay, so, like, you seem super cool and all, but I'm only really here because I'm interested in Morgan. She actually texted me saying, I'm asking if I'd go on this date with you, and I just was trying to do it for her as a favor.
Wait, I'm sorry. What?
Like, when she texted me, I was kind of just going on this date so that I could get closer with her.
So first of all, fuck you. In the nicest way possible, of course.
Thank you.
And second of all, you never said you're sorry.
Okay, I know this is fucked up. You're right.
This is why we can't have nice things.
Really? Taylor Swift? Isn't she your serial dater? What a role model.
I'm sorry, I'm still trying to process your stupidity.
Liza, I mean, I don't know you all that well, but didn't you just get out of a long relationship? I feel like you should take some more time to just process it more.
I told you I was over it, okay? And we only just met, you can't just make assumptions.
Okay, I mean, that's fair, but they're not assumptions if they're true. I already know you dated like 3 guys in my fraternity.
Who cares if I've dated the whole fraternity?
I mean, date me, please, but don't keep trying to force something that's not there.
I'm not forcing anything.
Well, you're on this date, aren't you?
I don't think I'd call this a date anymore. I'm just, I don't know, exploring new options. I don't know.
Am I really that new? We never met, but come on. I'm not trying to be a dick or anything. It just seems like you have some shit to figure out. But then again, don't we all?
Okay. I get what you're saying. But it just kind of seems like you have some communication skills to work on. But then again, don't we all? Ask Morgan on a date. She would appreciate your mismatch buttons more than